Hi guys, it's Millie Bobby Brown.
I'm Henry Cavill.
And I'm Superman.
And I'm Sam Claflin.
And we're in the new film, Enola Holmes.
Enola.
My God.
Today we'll be testing our knowledge of Victorian slang.
Here we go. The first one is bags of mystery.
It seems pretty self-explanatory, right?
Yeah, it's a bag of mystery.
It's just a bag of mystery.
One step ahead, always Enola Holmes, ladies and gentlemen.
You got to say it in their accent as well. Ah, oh, you know, bags of mystery.
Does everyone in Victorian Britain speak that? Ah, it's a bag of mystery.
I would say this is going quite well, wouldn't you?
I'm thinking it's like someone comes in with shopping bags. You walk in the door, someone goes, what's in the bag? Ah, oh, it's a bag of mystery.
Oh, it's food?
Pick and mix.
Is this a chocolate?
Turkish delight.
Oh.
Is it tea?
Oh, that's good.
Is that food, though? I don't know if I'd eat tea bags.
It might be a bag of roasted nuts.
You know how people used to make, like, meat pies? Is that right? Sorry, I got really excited. You know, like, just a bit like, oh, we'll chuck a bit of that in there, chuck a bit of that in there, yeah, bag of mystery. Oh, sausages.
Interesting.
Okay. That totally makes sense. They're still bags of mystery. Bricky.
It has to be,
Go on, Millie.
I really want to say it's a chocolate.
I feel like I've heard this through my school. Is it scared?
As in you're bricking yourself.
I'm bricking it. You used to say that as a kid. That means you're like, you're really scared. Feeling a bit bricky about this, guys.
Ooh, you don't say that anymore. You say I'm skirt, skirt.
Super annoying.
Like a brick wall.
Oh my God, John! Bricky, I would say smart, intelligent.
Plucky.
Witty, beautiful.
Bright but icky.
Loving, kind.
Humble.
Humble. Oh my God, what is it? Enola.
She's an absolute bricky.
Do you trust me?
No! Bang up to the elephant.
Does that mean there's no space?
Cramped.
Obviously, travelling circuses, you'd be bang up to the elephant if there was absolutely no space in your travelling whatever it was.
Hello.
Get out of this carriage right now.
Bang up to the elephant. I feel like it's like I'm going to turn up somewhere.
Put it in a sentence.
Like, I'm going to bang up to the elephant. The elephant's a pub near me. I'm going to go somewhere. I feel like that's what it means.
I'm sticking with my answer.
I'm going with Henry. He was Sherlock Holmes, after all. Yeah, we're doing really well with these guys.
Yeah.
I just want to know who came up with that.
The man who cleaned out the elephant's very cramped compartment.
He did a bang up to the elephant job.
Okay. Butter upon bacon.
That's got to mean just really good.
Is it a bit like tea bag or milk first? No, you put the butter upon the bacon.
Yeah, that's what I think. I think it's like butter upon bacon. Like, oh, I'm going to butter upon bacon.
I'm sorry?
Hey, Henry, what's that elephant idea again?
This one has nothing to do with elephants, that I know of.
Is it a bit like a comparison thing?
It's like chalk and cheese.
Which would you rather?
It's like butter and bacon.
Put us out of our misery.
What is it?
Oh, OK.
Unexpected.
We're spoiled nowadays, that's the problem. What is a chuckaboo?
It's definitely something you describe someone with.
Yeah, I'd say like my little chuckaboos.
A term of endearment.
That's what I would say. My little darlings.
That's the one.
Yeah, my little chuckaboos.
How did you know that?
Meter,
but spelt like meat.
How would they say it in America? You know, like a meter?
The meter maid?
Meter, this sounds like a big bare-knuckle boxer or something.
I was thinking more of like a butcher's. How are you going to go to the meter?
Get some bags of mystery for the old meter. No, I want butter upon the bacon. I would say a meter is someone that meets people. A bit like a greeter.
But with steaks.
Oh, it's sick.
Hello. Good to see you again.
You're an incompoop.
Oh, so the opposite of a bricky.
I wonder how meter became coward.
Well, cows offer meat. Anyway, nanty-narking.
I have a feeling.
Go for it.
This is like rambling. Like, oh, stop nanty-narking.
That really fits. Not even being sarcastic.
Thank you, Henry. For once.
When someone's narky, they're a bit like telling off.
Yeah, don't get narky.
Turning up.
Turning up.
I'm not too sure you can claim victory for that one, Millie. Skillamalink.
Sorry, is that?
Skillamalink. It's a character from The Hobbit.
I think this is a name we call someone.
You little skillamalink.
Oh, don't be such a skillamalink.
Like a thief?
A liar?
Pickpocket? He's just described that person, the Hobbit.
I am not the villain here.
Sauce box. I'd say that's like a compliment. Look at that little sauce box.
That's flattering.
Oh, she's saucy. He's saucy. That's saucy. This is saucy. Butter upon bacon. Bit saucy.
You're getting the point.
A beard?
It's got like a mouth.
Beard.
Like a mouth box.
Mouthy.
Sorry, did you say mouthy?
Well, I said mouth and there was no response. I was like, mouthy? Someone say something?
Take the egg.
You can take the egg. You can take this one.
You can take the car.
Take the egg and run with it.
Was it like a very early version of Pin the Tail on the Donkey? Find the egg with a blindfold in the hen hatch.
It's a game that you take people's eggs.
What's the expression? That one takes the biscuit.
Like a winner. He's a winner. He's a take the egg.
We did well.
What a bag of mystery.
Thank you so much for watching Chuckaboos. We hope that you enjoy our new film, Enola Holmes, only on Netflix.